Hello, brethren. Pray the Lord. He has been our keeper and he will always be. Let us say a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you very much for your safekeeping up to this time again. Every moment of our life is second chance, and you have always given it to us. And so we pray that we shall remain strong in you, given the circumstances that are around us. Bless us with these few verses from your word that are going to encourage us. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now, friends, I thank God again for this opportunity. I thank God who has given us life. I thank God who has kept us, because the Bible talks about him as one who never slumbers, as one who never sleeps. And so, since he never slumbers, since he never sleeps, the encouragement I come with today is be strong in the Lord. And so let us just concentrate on that, because it speaks multitudes to our lives. Everyone, everywhere needs a word of encouragement to remain strong, to remain standing. And so I just desire that we base ourselves on one verse, and then we shall add on several others. The verse that Paul gives to his listeners in the church at Ephesus. And Paul writes to them, encouraging them about very many things. And this verse is in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10. And I just want to read it verbatim. And so Paul says, "Finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his might." Finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his might. In this chapter, Paul had addressed several categories of people to keeping on and being at one with one another. First, he addresses the children to obey their parents because it is right in the Lord. Secondly, he talks to the fathers, that fathers, do not provoke your children to anger. And so that one was a message to the parents. He also addresses bond servants, those who are under authority and you are doing some work. And so he says, obey your earthly masters. He gives them this encouragement because it was necessary. And then he also addresses the masters and says, masters, do the same and stop and stop your threatening words to those that are under you. And so Paul addresses this category of people, and then he goes down and tells them, finally, my brothers, finally, brethren, finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his might. And so in verse 11, he tells them how they can do this. And of course, you know that in this, the following verses up to the end, Paul tells them to be clothed, to put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the schemes of the devil. And so in this verse of be strong in the Lord, I personally, on reading it, on thinking about it, actually not just thinking, but meditating upon it, I gain strength in the Lord. I gain strength even when I am doing my work. I gain strength while at home. I gain strength while at work. And so, Paul addressing this, be strong in the Lord, be strong in the Lord. Someone can be strong well in the body. But the moment you get weakened in the spirit, the moment you get weakened psychologically, the moment you get weakened intellectually, actually, your physical strength means nothing. Because I've seen huge people, I've seen big people. Someone, take an example, you are in class, you're a little boy, but very, very strong academically. Comes number one, comes number two, and this one is endowed physically. But you see, they are the ones who hold the tail. Because actually, all this. So when I'm talking about Paul talking to the Ephesians, be strong in the Lord, we are not only concentrating on one sphere of life that actually be strong, maybe physical strength, maybe academic strength, intellectual strength alone, or social strength alone, but being an all-round person. Because Paul knew that the Ephesians, among them, there are issues that would come and attack them. That's why he says, be strong in the Lord and put on the whole armor of God so that you may stand against the threats, the schemes of the devil. And so this is actually very, very important to me. And Paul knows very well that his strength would only come from the Lord, given the circumstances of his life. You know, Paul struggled with life also. As a human being, he was arrested many times. And yes, he says he was beaten many times. Yes, and he says he was abused many times. Yes, he says that actually he faced court charges very many times. But because he knew whom he believed in, he knew who had called him on his way when he was coming down to Damascus to persecute many Christians. He knew where he had come from. Now, in the same way, brethren, we all know where we've come from. We all know the situations that we are in, be it at family level, be it at workplace. And you know, even during this Corona times, Corona season, Corona pandemic, everything is in a mess. And leave alone Corona, but how about other circumstances in life that we face every day? You find someone actually having nothing to eat, no money. You find somebody, actually the relationship, family, husband, wife, parents, children. And actually, this time around, when our children have been home, this is when I commend teachers. Teachers do a lot of work. Schools have been, mentoring our children, and they've been away. But now, for the almost 2 years, our children at home, and then you find very many children, their parents are at loggerheads. I thank God that some of our families actually have remained strong in the Lord because we keep reading together. Some of us have taken it as an opportunity to sit with our children, interact with them for this time. But some people find it very, very difficult. Remember, actually, some of them are committing suicide everywhere. We are hearing stories of children committing, throwing the ropes in the necks, taking poison, running away from home because the conditions are not well. And so, my brothers, there are so many things that challenge us. And so when Paul says, finally, brethren, be strong in the Lord, he's addressing everybody, big or small, young or old. That's why he's talking out to the children. So any child, be strong in the Lord. You, father. And when we talk about the father, of course, actually put in the same bracket the mother. Be strong in the Lord. And when he talks about the bond servants, he's talking to the workers, those who are under authority, those who are under supervision. Be strong in the Lord. And then he talks to the masters, the some who don't value their people. I mean, they come with the boastful voices and shouting voices. He says, no, don't mistreat them. So when this happens, then we move on. So when Paul addresses all these categories of people, he's addressing all of us. And therefore he says, be strong in the Lord. And so I just want to share, to say that friends, in the world like this, we need to wait upon the Lord and be strong. And so David says it in Psalms 27, verse 14. And the reason why also, the same Paul mentioned something in Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, and he says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And to that one, I can say amen again. Because the strength that we have, some of us actually have been, frail, very, very weak. But God is good that we are up again. And because it is God who strengthens us. So each day that passes, each second that passes, each minute that passes, I personally take it as another chance that God has given me. And the strength, whether I'm speaking like I'm speaking now, whether I'm walking like, anything, if I'm able to stretch my hand, if I'm able to blink, that is the grace of God. And even you, my brother, my sister, that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And he says, all things. Now, this is something that we Christians You need to take on that all things, whatever you are doing, do it in the strength that the Lord has given you. Because you know that without Him, we are nothing. And all things are possible with the Lord. Now, Paul, in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1, and you know, Paul addressed Timothy as his son. And here he says, "You then, my child, be strengthened by the grace that is in Christ Jesus. And what you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses, entrust to faithful men who will be able to teach others also." So this verse 1, "You, my child, be strengthened in the Lord." And so I'm pointing to anyone who is listening to me, I mean watching this. Therefore, be strengthened in the Lord. Be strong in the Lord, in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. So the main admonition this time round is overcome weakness and renew your strength. Overcome weakness and renew your strength. And you will stand in the midst of whatever challenges that, even by the way, even in the good times, you need to be strong because you need the grace of the Lord. Now, finally, listen to this. Now, I enjoyed reading about the man David. David is my model, biggest model in the Bible. Of course, there are others like Joseph, like, you know, Gideon, Jephthah, you know, those men, Solomon, Paul, Peter, in the entire Bible. But one of them is David. Now, David was one of the kings of Israel. And there was a time when some things need to go well for him. And the Bible talks about his people plotting to stone him because he had taken a decision. You know, there are some decisions that we take that cause trouble for us. Maybe as a parent, maybe as a child, but you actually find trouble. Now, David was greatly distressed because of that decision that he took and what people were planning to do. And they were thinking of spoke of stoning him because all the people were bitter in Saul, each for his sons and their daughters. Now, the point is here. But David strengthened himself in the Lord his God. And well, there may not be anybody to encourage you. You may be alone. You may not have anyone to strengthen you. But the Bible is saying David strengthened himself. Now, if you can't tap from anywhere, then go into yourself. Meaning, actually, it is nice to store some strength within you so that if the outside is against you, then you are able to tap from within. The reason why I encourage you to pray all the time, strengthen yourself in the all the time, read God's word all the time. Even when the times are good, be empowered. Be strong. Store some strength. Can I say it again? Store some strength so that when the times are hard and difficult or what, you are able to tap from within. David tapped from within and he strengthened himself in the Lord. So my brothers and sisters, may God bless us to store some strength. I repeat, store some strength to tap on when you are in a state that is messy, when you are in a state that is difficult, and you'll be able to stand. And may God, who listens to our prayer, listen to this prayer that we're making, that he enables us to do all things through Christ who strengthens us. And Paul tells Timothy the same thing, and he has told the Ephesians the same thing. And I also tell you the same thing: be strong in the Lord, for he is good. And it's where we tap our strength, and when situations come, we look up. I remember Abraham looking up. I remember other people looking up. And so, because our citizenship is in heaven, but before we get to there, we are still here on earth. Let us keep ourselves strong in the Lord, for he is good and able to continue sustaining us. Amen. May God bless you and keep you well. Father, we thank you that you have given us this time. I pray that you bless everyone visiting and listening to this, that we shall be strengthened physically, spiritually, emotionally, socially, and all spheres of life, that we shall be able to face the situations that are in our lives, in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.